The shaitan, he came to that man and he said, look what you've done. And then that young girl, she fell pregnant and she gave birth to a young boy, a baby boy. And the shaitan, he again came to this man. Look at the way the shaitan is trying to grab hold of him. And the shaitan, one day he came up and he says, look what you've done. People are going to find out. Do you think people are stupid? This young girl, when she carries a young baby, what are people going to think? The only way you can get out of this, go and kill that baby. So this pious man, he goes and he kills that baby and he buries that baby in that same hut that young girl lives. One day the shaitan came up to that pious man again and he said, you fool, do you think that this girl is just going to shut up? Is she not going to tell her brothers when they come back? You're going to get into deep trouble. Do the same what you did with that baby, get rid of her. That pious man, he went and he strangled that girl and he buried her with that baby in that same hut. Her brothers came back from jihad a few days later. They came back from jihad and they went to the pious man and they said, where's our sister? And he says, your sister, she fell so ill and she died. I'll take you to her grave. So he took them to the graveyard where a newly dug grave was. And they said, and he lied and he says, this is your sister's grave. And they said, Fatiha. They cried for a while and they went back to that same hut they were living. That same night when these brothers went to sleep, they saw a dream. The shaitan came into their dreams one by one. The shaitan, he came into the dreams of all the brothers and the shaitan, he said, do you know what really happened to your sister? And he told them the whole story. And then when these brothers, they wake up in the morning and they meet each other and they start telling the dream they have. And the younger brother, he says that I'm going to find out what happened to my sister. And the others, they say that, no, don't be a fool. He's a pious man. Why? Don't even think about him that way. And the younger brother, he goes, what if we find out? And if he's innocent, he's innocent. At least we find out the truth. And they went to that pious man. And they threatened him. If you do not tell us the truth, we are going to kill you. And because this pious man now was fearing for his own life, he told every single thing what happened. These three brothers, they went to the king and they told him everything. The king, he ordered this pious man to be hanged. When the day came that this pious man was to be hanged, the shaitan came again to him. And he says, I am the one who was giving you them thoughts and ideas. I am your partner who made you commit adultery. I am the one who made you kill that baby. I am the one who made you kill that young girl as well. I am the one. And the shaitan, he says, do you want me to help you today? I can help you if you want. And that pious man now, because he was fearful, he was scared of losing his life, he goes, tell me what you want me to do. And the shaitan at that time, he came to his plan, why he had done all that. And my dear Islamic brothers, we should all be fearful. The shaitan, he came up to that person and he says, that deny the oneness of Allah, I will help you today. Deny the oneness of Allah. Look where the story started from. And now the shaitan, he came in his own form and he says to that man, deny the oneness of Allah and I will save you. That man, he started thinking to himself. And then after a short while, he says, I deny the oneness of Allah. I become a kafir. Help me. And as soon as he said these words, the trap opened and he was hanged and he died as a kafir. And the shaitan, he vanished with his friends. He went laughing. He goes, we've done our part. We've destroyed his iman. Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran, كَمَا قَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِذْ قَالَ لِلْإِنسَانِ اكْفُرْ فَلَمَّا كَفَرْ قَالَ إِنِّي بَرِيءٌ مِنْكَ إِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهَ رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Translation from comes with iman. Like shaitan, when he said to the man, disbelieve. And then when he disbelieved, he said, I quit from you because I fear Allah, Lord of the worlds. The shaitan will make you all or commit all these sins. And then the shaitan, my dear Islamic brothers, he will run away from you. The shaitan will make you commit all these gunas, all these sins, and he will run away from you. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, he taught us a dua. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min fitnatin nisa wa adab al-qabr. Oh Allah, save us from the fitna of the women and save us from the punishment of the grave. A woman, my dear Islamic brothers, today how many brothers do we see on the street? How many Muslims do we see on the street with holding the hands of a girl? Never mind holding their hands, my dear Islamic brothers. There are so many Muslims who are out there who are committing adultery every day and every night. These people are committing these sins. And committing adultery is a very, very serious sin. And there are so many brothers out there. There are so many stories of Islamic sisters coming and crying and saying, well, I was married 5 years ago. I've got two young children. And my husband, I've heard that he's having an affair with someone else. Look at the azab. Today we say that why are all these problems coming to us? It is because we all earned it. It is because of our action. It is because we have left the way of the Quran and the Sunnah. My dear Islam brothers, it is because of all that. We are so proud of ourselves. People are talking, yeah, I've got a girlfriend. Yeah, this is my girlfriend. I went out with her and this is what we did. You should be ashamed of yourself. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-'aliyyil 'azim. Let me tell you, my dear Islam brothers, this was an ibrat for us. This is something which we learn a lesson from. But how many people are going to learn a lesson from that? Jahan mein hai ibrat ke har sunamune, magar kuch ko anda kiya hai rango bune. We are blind. We don't know what is happening. We are blindfolded. We are walking. We are zombies. We don't know what is happening to us. The shaitan has taken control of our hearts today. The shaitan can take us to the pub tomorrow and he can take us somewhere else tomorrow. The shaitan is manipulating. He's playing with your minds. He's got control of your heart. This is why he said, don't let the shaitan play about with your hearts. Today we can see that, my dear Islam brothers, how many Muslims are coming to the masjid. The shaitan has made our hearts a toy. कभी गौर से भी ये देखा है तूने जो आबाद थे वो महल थे अब है सूने. So many mansions people have built in this world. People have built palaces. Where are they? Them palaces are still there. The people who lived in them palaces are no more. कभी गौर से भी ये देखा है तूने जो आबाद थे वो महल अब है सूने. जगह जी लगाने की दुनिया नहीं है. ये इबरत की जा है, तमाशा नहीं है. This is not a world where you come and you enjoy yourself and you're going to go and that is it. This is a place, this is an exam room for you, my dear Islam brothers. And we are failing that exam today. Ajal ne na chora, na kisra, na dara. Isi se Sikandar sa fateh bihara. Do you know about Sikandar Azam? Do you know about Alexander the Great? He was the one who was going to conquer the whole world. What happened to him? Death overtook him. Sikandar Azam, Alexander the Great, when he died, he said to the people, put my hands outside my shroud, outside my coffin, so that people look at me, that this is that Sikandar, this is that Alexander, who wanted to conquer the whole world, is going empty-handed. What are you going to take with you? You have no namaz, you have no roza, you have no charity, we have no good deeds. What are we going to take with us, my dear Islamic brothers? Leke kya kya na hasrat sidara. Because so many plans in this world. Jaga ji lagane ki duniya nahi hai. Ye ibrat ki ja hai, tamasha nahi hai.